Let's say you are already committed to be a tither and a promisor, but the only thing is that, well, you don't have any income. What should you do? Are you expected to find a way to get money anyway so that you may fulfill your vows? Should you sell something you own in order to give? Ask your boss for an advance? Borrow money from a friend? Can someone still be considered a tither and a promisor without having an income? Of course. The idea is pretty simple. Being a tither and a promisor is a decision made from a heart that accepts God as the owner and source of all material blessings. This acceptance depends on your submission to Him and to His Word. It's not about money. God will never expect tithe and promise from someone who hasn't received anything from Him. Once again, we don't tithe in order to be blessed. Actually, we tithe because we have already been blessed. Same thing goes for your promise. In both cases, a previously established percentage is offered from what you receive from God. So the tithe for zero income is zero. The promise for zero income is, once again, zero. And in this case, even when you return nothing, you're still considered faithful. But hey, there is something you can do about it. You may pray to the Lord and remind Him that you are already a tither and a promisor. That following His word, you will return to Him as tithe and promise determined percentages of all that He will give you. Then, ask Him to give you an income if He wants you to help forwarding His work in this world. For we know that every giving starts with God's giving. The Lord upholds all who fall and raises up all who are bowed down. The eyes of all look expectantly to you, and you give them their food in due season. You open your hand and satisfy the desire of every living thing. Psalm 145, verses 14 through 16. May we put our desires last and God first.